Renovation revealed the multi-million dollar plans to make over the Citrus Bowl unveiled tonight to residents and business owners who have the stadium in their backyard. WESH 2's Stephanie Culp live in the community. And Stephanie, this will be a lot of work in a short amount of time.
Yeah, Sienna, a major facelift is about to happen to the Citrus Bowl, which you can see just beyond the lake there. But if we take a few steps and swivel the camera around, you can see that the Citrus Bowl has neighbors. In fact, this is in a relatively residential area, and it's the people that live here that need to be concerned about the construction. Big events are common at the Citrus Bowl, but an even bigger event is about to happen here, a $191 million renovation. Workers will keep only 10% of what you see now, demolishing the rest of the bowl and rebuilding it.
It is old, dilapidated. Even though we put about $6 million in it about 5 or 6 years ago, we really need to upgrade it, reconstruct it, so we can compete for larger venues.
But with construction comes concern. City leaders met with residents to warn them of four major headaches: noise, dust, night work, and road closures. Construction teams promise to be good neighbors during the process, and many residents realize it's a necessary evil.
We have ongoing events at the stadium, and we see it as not just noise, but as a money-making proposition also.
Hard hats could become the norm on the west side of I-4 near downtown, with a soccer stadium looking more and more likely and the Amway Center looking to expand. Not everyone, though, thinks it's money well spent for the neighborhood of Paramore. Josh Palladino is running for county commission and protested the community event.
And it's another stadium in the black community doing what it does best, eliminating the poor, eliminating small business, small black business from the community for economic prosperity that never comes.
And you'll see preparation for the construction starting this fall, with major work starting in January, and construction is expected to wrap up in November of 2014. Reporting live tonight in Orlando, Stephanie Culp, WESH 2 News on CW18.